Hello chess friends, welcome back to the chess move of the day. Like always, we bring you something special in the move of the day, and today's move of the day is going to be focused on Anand's game. So here is a game of Vishwanathan Anand, and this point he was 99, it was in 99.3 I suppose. So this was very young Anand playing against Lautier, and this game became so famous, and it was like one of the most popular game in the 1990s. This move was really celebrated, and Anand found it quite effortlessly. So, like always, go ahead, pause the video, try to find the move, try to find the brilliant move that Anand played here. Alright, so let's go for it. In this position, white played bishop to g6. Now, this is absolutely brilliant. Basically, it's hanging two of the pieces. First of all, the strongest piece, that's a queen. So, Anand hangs his queen. At the same time, the bishop hangs on g6. But it is totally winning. Let's have a look at what happens. In the game, basically, knight to e7 was played. But let's have a look at what happens if he captures our queen. Well, in that case, we have rook takes e6. That's a capture. That's a check. And you can see the pawn cannot really capture because of the pin over here. The king has to step aside. King to f8. And here comes bishop to h6. Check. King goes in the corner. And now bishop to f7 is a form of a Bowden's mate. Excellent checkmate. And that's the reason the queen cannot be captured over here. So after the move bishop to g6, he cannot take our queen because of rook e6. That's the reason here he played knight to e7. Anand now went on to exchange queens with queen takes d4, rook takes d4. And he calculated that he's already better. And he can simply continue with something like rook to d3, which he played in the game, offering the exchange of rooks. Black obviously resigned. Black obviously declined, not resigned yet. He declined the offer of exchange, but now white goes on, exchanges. After king takes, white simply brings back his bishop, reminding black that look at your bishop. That bishop is still trapped. You still have a lot of issues to deal with. In fact, bishop cannot go to h3 because of king g3, and that traps the bishop. The only logical square for the bishop is to go to h1. Basically, it was in this position that Anand's opponent resigned, but let's have a look at what happens if the natural bishop to h1 is played. Now you can see Anand can't really play king g1 attacking the bishop because bishop into f3 is threatened. There is something else that he can play. In fact, the king's position as well as the rook's position is so vulnerable that Anand is gonna have a zugzwang position in just about two moves. Here we go. First move, bishop to b2. That attacks the rook, puts him a question, where do you want to put the rook? Black plays rook to e8 because he knew that the bishop is going to come to f6 in order to attack it twice. That's the reason he put it on e8 in a defensive manner. And here comes bishop to f6. Basically, it's an absolute zugzwang. This position is an absolute zugzwang. No matter what you play, it's totally, totally busted. It's totally lost position for black. You can try several moves. At one point, black will run out of move. He'll have to either move the king or the rook, in which case he's going to drop material. His bishop on h1 is cursed, can't really move. Rook on e8 is cursed, can't move. Knight is pinned. King can't move because we are going to take the knight. And the pawns, they are going to run out of moves. They have few moves, of course. Pawns can make some moves, but he will soon run out of pawn moves. And basically, it will be a totally dead lost position. So what a wonderful game by Vishwanathan Anand. And here is the star move of the game. Bishop to g6, hanging two pieces at the same time, yet totally winning the game. So, hope you enjoyed this excellent chess game by Vishwanathan Anand. This was in the 1990s, and this game was really popular. And in fact, this is one of is considered to be among top 5 of Anand's best chess games. So, until next time, see you guys.